Hello everyone and welcome back. This is William and today we're going to continue to explore a generalization of the block tiling problem we saw in the last video. Previously we looked at how to tile a 1x n board with tiles of lengths 1 and 2. We observed that the recurrence f of n equals f of n minus 1 plus f of n minus 2 gave the number of tilings for a board of length n. Today we're going to ask the generalization of the problem, which is, how do we count the number of tilings when we have blocks of different lengths and blocks of the same length but different colors? Again, you can assume that there is an infinite amount of each block size and color. For instance, as you can imagine, there are numerous ways to tile a board of length 7 with the four different block sizes displayed above. You can have a purple block, a red block, a purple block followed by a green block, or maybe two red blocks, two purple blocks, a blue block followed by a red block, and so on. Let's define the function f of n to be the number of tilings for a board of length n. My question for you is, what is the value of f of 25? That is, how many ways are there to tile a board of length 25 with the tiles displayed on this screen? I'll give you a moment to think about it, but here are a few hints to get you started. F of 1 equals 2. F of 2 equals 5, and F of 7 equals 452. I encourage you to pause the video here and give the problem a try. I'm going to reveal the solution in the following slide. So according to my calculations, F of 25 is a pretty large number, 5,331,133,626. It's actually not uncommon for these combinatorial dynamic programming problems to yield such large results because the answers tend to grow very quickly. The approach we're going to use to calculate f of n is to construct all the ways to tile boards of length 1, then construct all the ways to make boards of length 2, then all boards of length 3, and so on. As we do this, you'll notice that we will be able to reuse smaller known board tiling solutions to construct larger boards. We're going to look at how to solve the problem using the bottom-up approach we looked at in the last video. First, we need to consider all the ways there are to tile a board of length 0. That may sound trivial, but it's the base case or the foundation by which our dynamic programming solution is based off of. So there's exactly one way to make a board of length 0, and that's to have the empty board state. From the empty state, there are exactly two ways to make a board of length 1. We can either tile the board of length 1 using a red block, or tile a board of length 1 using a purple block. There are no other ways to make a board of length 1 because our other tiles, the blue and green tiles, are too large to even fit on the board at the moment. Next, we're going to construct all the boards of length 2. To do this, we are going to reuse all the solutions from boards of length 1 to construct boards of length 2 by appending a red block to all the solutions as well as a purple block. You will notice that we are able to create a board with a blue tile for the first time. One way to think about this is that we are adding a blue tile to the empty state to create a board of length 2. Now you can see that there are exactly 5 ways to create a board of length 2. Next, we are going to construct all boards of length 3. Similar to before, we are going to use all the board tilings of length 2 to create boards of length 3 by adding a red and purple tile. We are also going to reuse all boards of length 1 plus a blue tile to create a board of length 3. You may already be seeing the pattern here, but essentially for every block of length k that fits on the board, We are going to add on all the solutions from k columns ago and add them to the current tiling count. So in this situation, there is 5 plus 5 plus 2 for a total of 12 tilings of length 3. Based on the previous example, try and determine how many ways there are to tile a board of length 4. Pause the video if you need more time. In order to find all the tilings for a board of length 4, append blocks to the existing solutions from previous board sizes which result in a board of length 4. So in total, there are 30 ways to tile a board of length 4. Let's take a look at how we might discover the recurrence relation to count the number of board tilings. The realization from the previous example is that we can reuse already known solutions from smaller board sizes to compute f of n. For instance, suppose we have a tile of length k that we can use to fill boards. If we get all the tilings of length n minus k and append a block of length k, then we have just generated a new unique set of tilings of length n using the block of size k. If you assume that we only had a single block of length k to tile boards with, then the recurrence would be pretty simple. It would be f of n equals f of n minus k. However, if we added another block of length h to our set of available blocks, then the recurrence would become f of n equals f of n minus k plus f of n minus h. Because blocks of length h are a different color, they generate their own unique set of tilings that need to be accounted for in the recurrence. Coming back to our original question, what is the recurrence when we have two blocks of length 1, one block of length 2, and one block of length 4? Well, in this case, the recurrence is f of n equals f of n minus 1 for the red block plus f of n minus 1 for the purple block plus f of n minus 2 for the blue block plus f of n minus 4 for the green block. Since f of n minus 1 is repeated, we can further simplify the recurrence by combining the f of n minus 1 terms. This brings us to the generalization of the problem, and as we attempt to derive a general solution, we quickly discover that the recurrence relation is due to two important factors. First, the length of the tiles at our disposal, and secondly, the frequency of the tile lengths. Using that information, we are able to conjure up a linear recurrence which incorporates the lengths of the tiles and the frequency of the tile lengths. The length of the tiles is used to determine the offset in the function to get the board length, and the frequency of the tile lengths is used to determine the coefficients in front of the terms in the linear recurrence. All right. Let's take a look at some pseudocode on how to implement the generalized tiling recurrence. Let's begin with the iterative solution. This is the code for the iterative solution. The approach here is to use the bottom-up solution presented earlier. Let's walk through it. As input, we provide n, the board length we want to solve for, as well as the list containing the tile lengths of all the tiles we have at our disposal. In the example at the beginning of the video, we would have specified n equals 25 and the tiles list equal to the numbers 1, 1, 2, and 4. To start with, I declare an array called dp of length n plus 1 to store all the solutions for the values of f of n. Since we know the value for f of 0, we immediately set the value of f of 0 to equal 1 as the base case. The next thing I do is declare a map data structure called tile frequency, which counts the frequency of each tile length. Then I iterate over all the tiles and count the frequency of each tile length. In this loop, the variable I represents the board length. So we iterate from I equals 1, meaning a board of size 1, up to a board of size n. Then inside the loop, we loop through all the unique tile lengths. Then we skip the tiles which are larger than the current board size, since they can't fit on the board, and sum up the number of ways to tile the board by adding up all the values in the linear recurrence. To do this, we need to add up the number of ways to tile the board at the current length minus the tile size and multiplied by the frequency of the tile length. After the loops have completed, the DP array should be populated and we can return the value of f of n. Let's also have a look at the recursive implementation. I think it's important to understand how to implement a problem in more than one way to expand how you approach certain problems. Sometimes a problem will be easier for you if you think about it iteratively. Sometimes it'll be easier for you if you think about it recursively. The idea behind the recursive implementation is largely the same concept, except that instead of solving the problem bottom up, we're going to be solving it top down. To do that, we are going to break the board down into smaller boards instead of building larger boards from smaller boards. On the first line, I declare a map called DP, which maps the board length to the tile count. This is where we will be storing our solutions. I decided to use a map instead of an array because it's possible that the number of subproblems is very small. This can happen when the tile size is quite large, and by using a map, we can save some memory when the value of n is very big. The recursive implementation takes the same inputs as the iterative approach: n, the board size, and the tiles array. Inside the solve function, all I do is stage a call to the recursive function f. In addition to the board length, I also provide the tile frequency map as another argument to the function, which gets calculated below in the compute tile frequency method. First, we declare a map called TF, short for tile frequency, which maps the tile length to the number of tiles of that length. Then we do a simple loop through the tiles and compute the frequency for each tile length. Now, let's take a look at the recursive function itself, which is what actually computes the different board tiling configurations. As input to the function, we provide n, the current board length, and tf, the tile frequency of each tile length. The tile frequency map is actually constant. You could pull it out to simplify this function if you wanted to. The first thing I do is check if the board length is negative. If so, return 0 to indicate that we were able to produce 0 board tilings. It is possible to get a negative board length when we subtract the tile length from the board size in the recursive call below. Next, we check if we have successfully completed tiling a board. If so, we can return that there is exactly one way to tile the board using the tiles that were placed. The next thing we do is check the cache to see if we have already computed the solution for f of n and return a result if we have. This is the optimization that really speeds up the recursive implementation, since we're avoiding recomputing already known solutions to subproblems. Afterwards, we actually compute the number of different ways to tile the board. To do this, we compute the solution for f of n using the linear recurrence relation described previously. This involves looping through the tiles of different lengths and summing up the solutions for all the smaller board sizes we were able to create, taking into account the frequency of each tile length. After all the recursive calls have finished, we can cache the solution for f of n and return the tile count. All right, and that's all for board tilings. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something, and catch you next time. Please remember to like this video and subscribe for more mathematics and computer science content. Thank you.